I mentioned that every 53 seconds an American suffers a stroke. Another statistic, every 3 minutes an American dies from a stroke. But there are new guidelines from the American Stroke Association that could cut the death rate by almost 20%. And in a moment, we're going to show you those guidelines in action. But the first step in recognizing a stroke are knowing what the symptoms are. Number one, sudden numbness or weakness of face, arms, or legs, especially on one side of the body. Or possibly sudden confusion, trouble speaking or understanding. Sudden trouble seeing in one or both eyes. Sudden trouble walking, dizziness, loss of balance or coordination, or sudden severe headache with no known cause. Now, these could be symptoms of something else, but if you have any of them, you shouldn't take any chances. You should get yourself to a hospital and get there in an ambulance, because that could save you even more precious time. Now, Robin Roberts knows all too well how important all this is. Her mother has had two strokes in the last 2 years, and Robin's sister, Dorothy, had a stroke at age 44. They both got treated right away, and they are both okay. But Robin thought it would be a good idea to join us from one of the first hospitals in the country to put the new guidelines into action, St. Mary Medical Center in Langhorne, Pennsylvania.
Here at St. Mary Medical Center, they have a primary stroke center. They follow the guidelines of the American Stroke Association. Dr. Emil Matarese is the director, and calling 911 right away, that's really key, isn't it, doctor?
You're right, Robin. You did just the right thing. If you were really a stroke patient, time is of the essence. You got the ambulance there. These paramedics were already able to start emergency treatment en route to the hospital. They were able to take vital information. They started blood work. They've done your examination. They've started IV, and they've called critical information here to the stroke unit. We are already waiting for you.
So they already called ahead. They called ahead, so they know everything.
That's right. And our team has already been assembled. This way, we can very rapidly evaluate your problem and determine if this is a stroke, and we could treat you emergently for that. There's going to be a team you'll see. The first is the emergency room physician.
One, two, three.
And Robin, I'm Dr. Soni. I'm the ER physician. If you are a stroke patient here today, I'll be asking you questions like if you have a sudden onset of any weakness in any part of your body, if you have a problem with your vision, if you have a problem with your speech. And during the exam, I'll be doing a full neurological exam. I'll be listening to your heart and lungs. And as you know, the scenario we're dealing with today, we think the patient is already having a stroke, and we have activated our stroke team.
And who else is a part of this team here?
At that point, what we have is we have Don, who's our ER tech. His responsibility is to put you on the monitor, get oxygen on you, change you into, again, get an EKG. Kim here is a registered nurse. She's going to put in a second IV line, get the blood work done, and check the blood glucose to make sure it's not your sugar. And then my responsibility is to make sure everything's done in a timely fashion.
Time is of the essence.
Time is of the essence for stroke.
As the neurologist, I'll then step in and I'll do an examination. I quickly need to check your body. I'll do things like checking your pupils, how your eyes move. I'll check your strength. You pull towards me, you push away, and I can assess very quickly whether or not the patient appears to have had a stroke. And if you're a stroke patient, we're going to head right over for a CAT scan. And they've already been alerted, so they're waiting for us, and they're
already on route there. What are we going to do here? Why are we going to the CAT scan?
Well, the CAT scan is critical at this point because the CAT scan is going to be allowing us to very easily see pictures of that brain. We'll be doing slices of your brain that will tell us whether or not there's any evidence of a bleed. If a patient presents as you did all the right things. You presented within the first 3 hours of the onset of your symptoms. If a patient presents that quickly, we have a chance of potentially reversing the deficits from your stroke. So what we'll be doing is treating you with this emergency medication, and the CAT scan is critical because the CAT scan allows me to determine whether or not there's a bleed.
And that will determine if I can have TPA, which is
the
new drug.
This new medication needs to be administered within the first 3 hours of the onset of a patient's symptoms.
Within the first 3 hours
to
be effective?
That's right. In fact, the quicker we get that medication in the better we have. Okay, just don't move. We're looking at pictures of your brain, and the slices are showing that the brain itself looks normal. I believe we've caught this in time, and if you were a stroke patient, we'd be able to offer you the TPA, and I'm going to come in now and speak to you about that.
So I would be eligible for TPA because you didn't see any bleeding?
That's correct.
Okay.
You did all the right things. You arrived in a timely fashion. We have the window of 3 hours, but the best results occur in patients who are treated within the first 1 hour. You knew to call 911. You didn't waste time. You had your treatment started in the ambulance. The paramedics were able to phone ahead, give us valuable information to assemble our team, and to save every possible precious second.
And from here, I would go where?
From here, we're going to go back to the emergency room. We have to treat you as quick as possible with the TPA, and then you'll be admitted to our intensive care unit. You'll be with us 24 hours, and then after that, you'll be rehabilitating in our acute stroke center.
In the 10 years since Good Morning America clip aired, St. Mary's has made a lot of progress in treating stroke with new therapies and advanced interventions. As a primary stroke center, we still offer one of the region's most experienced stroke emergency response teams to quickly evaluate and effectively treat stroke 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. To distinguish St. Mary as a comprehensive stroke center, we have expanded the specialized care needed to improve the outcomes of patients with stroke and complex cerebral vascular disease. As part of a major investment in an advanced neurosciences center, St. Mary added state-of-the-art operating rooms to allow neurosurgeons to perform minimally invasive procedures, including complex transcatheter interventions. Neurosurgeons can now deliver targeted TPA directly to the site of a clot in the brain, and in some cases, extend the time frame for reversing the devastating side effects of stroke. And St. Mary recently made history as the first neuroscience center on the East Coast to use the Solitaire Flow Restoration device to retrieve a clot in the brain of a man suffering a major stroke. St. Mary was able to perform this procedure because of a unique relationship with Jefferson Neurosurgery. Other exciting medical advancements use catheter-based endovascular procedures to place stents, coils, and even special glues to treat hemorrhagic strokes and stop bleeding in the brain. St. Mary has a new intensive care unit providing advanced care for critically ill patients. Therapeutic hypothermia and precise monitoring of pressure and electrical activity in the brain are among the complex care provided to stroke patients by specialty trained physicians and nurses. For patients continuing on the road to recovery, St. Mary has skilled rehabilitation specialists certified in brain injury who provide speech, physical, and occupational therapies to help patients return to a normal lifestyle and their highest level of function. And later this year, St. Mary will begin construction of a freestanding rehabilitation hospital with a dedicated unit for people recovering from stroke. St. Mary Medical Center is among a distinguished group of U.S. hospitals to earn national recognition for complying with the latest guidelines for the treatment of stroke. St. Mary has earned the Joint Commission's Gold Seal of Approval as a primary stroke center and has been recognized by the American Heart, American Stroke Association for its consistent adherence to Get With the Guidelines, Achievement Indicators, and Quality Measures. These quality distinctions recognize that St. Mary's is providing the highest level of quality care for the treatment of stroke, including rapid assessment and treatment. We are committed to raising awareness for stroke risk factors, educating consumers regarding the signs and symptoms of stroke, and stressing the importance of seeking immediate medical attention when those signs and symptoms present themselves. Some of the ways St. Mary does this is by partnering with groups like the American Stroke Association to help spread the word about the debilitating and often deadly medical emergency. Thank you for your time. And please remember, when dealing with strokes, time is brain.